Hello everyone, hope you're having the most wonderful day today. Welcome to Film Insight. For today's video, we're going to discuss even more Kitchen Nightmares contestants and what they're doing now. So sit back, relax, and without further ado, let's get right into the content, guys. D-Place. Remember D-Place? On the second episode of the second season of Kitchen Nightmares, we paid a visit to D-Place. The future of the bar was hanging on the line, but was Chef Gordon able to redeem it? For how long did the bar run after that, and where are they now? You'll find out by the end of the video. For those who missed the episode, D-Place used to be a very popular cafe bar, located in the heart of Chelmsford, Essex. The bar was opened by Mexican-born Israel Ponce 5 years ago, and run together with his English partner, Tara. Initially, the bar was doing so well, and had garnered so many customers within the space of 2 years. During the time the business boomed, though, Israel proved himself to be quite the entrepreneur, building 5 businesses within the space of a few years. Unfortunately for Israel and Tara, the success of the business was short-lived, and he eventually had to fall back on D-Place. After investing £150,000 and taking a loan worth £25,000 from the National Brewery, Israel found himself struggling to keep afloat. Sales had dropped by more than 50% compared to the previous years, and Israel was barely hanging on. And then Israel did what every smart chef or business owner would do. He put the call through to Gordon Ramsay. Desperate and trying to win back customers, Israel employed Philippe Blaise as the executive chef. Philippe was obviously a good choice, with 25 years of experience and a love for English-made delicacies. At D-Place, Philippe had to make do with just 3 chefs working for him and very few customers to cook for, nothing like his time at Planet Hollywood. In this particular episode of Kitchen Nightmares, it's Valentine's night, but while love wafts solidly in the air, out of the 84 seats available at D-Place, only 24 of them were booked. Oopsie, seemed like D-Place just wasn't the place to be on Valentine's night, as Chef Ramsay was there with just 7 days to transform the restaurant. Chef Ramsay sits at one of the restaurant tables, ready to have a great time. A picture of his wife, Tanya, sits on a table next to him as he orders from the Valentine's menu. Gordon orders a scallop and shrimp cocktail and Monsieur Creme Brulee for dessert. When the food arrives, Chef Ramsay is not impressed with the scallops. The scallops are rubber-like and overcooked, and the shrimp cocktail is served with microwaved rice and a runny creme brulee. This births an argument between the head chef, Philippe, and one of the chefs, Dave. Dave admonishes Philippe to focus on quality rather than quantity, and that he should stop serving bad dishes that would make him look stupid in front of the customers. This rebuke spirals down into a very loud argument, so loud that even some customers can overhear it. Orders in advance and reheat them when an order comes in because the oven is very slow. And the food that leaves the kitchen? So bad that the customers keep rejecting it for one reason or the other. It was beginning to get so clear while the once booming restaurant became a ghost of its former self. In some cases, the customers were left waiting for up to 45 minutes before the food arrived, which they would almost certainly eventually send back to the kitchen. Gordon had to sit with his Israel to discuss the state of his kitchen. The standards were low. Philippe was not doing his best. Something needed to be done. While Israel explained how much he'd lost confidence in the business, Gordon advised him to be strong. Next, Gordon needed to settle the feud between Philippe and Dave, and there was only one way to do it. Both Philippe and Dave had to come clean about how they felt towards each other. Pretty intense moment there, but at the end of the day, the two chefs resolved their differences. Gordon tells them how important communication and understanding are in the kitchen, and both Dave and Philippe agree to keep the communication channels open. Gordon then has a personal meeting with Philippe to talk to him about leadership in the restaurant. The younger chefs were looking at him and following in his footsteps, especially with regards to the quality of service that the restaurant delivered. Just like Israel, Philippe had also lost huge hope in the restaurant. But Gordon challenges him too, and once his spirit is raised and the feud's dissolved, Gordon feels that the time has come to get the knives cutting and the pans sizzling with freshness. The menu's updated to include more classic French dishes, and Philippe is given more of the right tools he needs to improve his cooking. Then there's the croque monsieur of a new sandwich that feel like a taste of heaven. Finally, something worth serving. And though Israel is skeptical about the menu changes, Gordon believes that this freshness is exactly what the restaurant needs to save it. Gordon makes the chefs undertake a team-building exercise to foster communication and harmony between the staff. For this exercise, each team, including 2 chefs, are tasked to make guacamole. But here's the twist. The chef making the dish was blindfolded, while the other was tasked with telling him what to do. Dave and Philippe were on the same team, and surprisingly, their guacamole turned out to be the best. But while the internal bond had improved between the owner and the chefs, what did this spell for D-Place? After redecorating the dining room, cleaning up the kitchen, fixing the slow oven, and bringing in some of the best kitchen equipment, Gordon taught the chef some quick, easy meals. The exterior is renamed Saracen's Cafe Bar, and both owners and chefs work together to see that everything is perfect. On relaunch day, Saracen's Cafe Bar is fully booked for lunch. However, the team still manages to mess it up regardless, even though they only have three orders on. For some reason, they couldn't seem to get the one dish they had practiced right. Communication broke down and some of the tickets were lost while the customers waited for their meals, hungry. The customers that did get their food loved it, but the ticket confusion was a big issue for the bar. Tensions mounted and Philippe finally lost it when a dish he'd already served was returned. Gordon reaches out and talks with him. Eventually, the chef continues to finish the service. At the end of the day, the blame game begins again. Israel says the problem is with the manager. Dave disagrees and an argument ensues. Dave refuses to take the blame and repeatedly shouts at Israel. Israel fires him on the spot, and to save an already horrific day at the bar, Israel has to give over £100 worth of complimentary food and drinks to avoid further embarrassment before he finally shuts down the service that only lasted for an hour and 20 minutes. Gordon advises them to take it one step at a time. A few customers first, then more, until they're confidently taking up more volume. At the point where Gordon is about to leave, the future looked bleak for the Chelmsford restaurant. He leaves Israel with one word: keep breathing down their necks. But could Israel demand quality in every bite? Well, following such beautiful renovations, we would expect that D Place would last for another few years. But on Gordon's return just 6 weeks after, D Place was already closed down. Unfortunately, only a month after he had left the restaurant, it went into receivership and the National Brewery had to take back the facility and put the lease up for sale. Gordon meets Philippe there and asks him about the business. The sandwiches are now popular, but Israel and Tara had lost just about everything. Gordon decides to pay a visit to Israel and Tara. He wants to help, but it is too late. They had already lost the business. But Gordon is not an accountant or a financial advisor. There was only so much he could do. D Place was eventually bought by new owners, who renamed the restaurant, and fortunately for Dave, these new owners were also kind enough to give him his job back as a chef in the restaurant. Philippe Blaise said they had people complaining about the new menu, but it was obvious in the episode they were going to struggle to turn it around. It was never the brightest future for the original owners of D Place, Israel and Tara, but since the transfer of the property to the new owners by the influence of the National Brewery, Saracen's has so far remained open and is highly successful.